Welcome to Keeping It Real, a state with the Twins Group, your source of real and simple tips in navigating the real estate industry.
Well, hello and welcome, friends, to Wind Down Wednesday. I'm Kristy Losey, and we want to welcome you to Keeping It Real Estate with the Twins Group.
And I'm Kelly Howard, so welcome to our second podcast. I'm so excited to be here and have our second podcast.
Okay, cheers.
So this is where we keep it real and simple while discussing the real estate industry. So Kristy, what is our topic today?
Well, today we are going to discuss how you kind of break into the industry. Kelly and I have been asked over the years, how do I get in the industry? How do I start? What do I do? So today we thought we would discuss a little bit about how you get in the real estate industry, but also more importantly, how do you choose a home? How do you find a place to work? And how do you select the perfect place for you to work and build your business?
So there are many branches in the real estate industry, really depending on what area you would like to be in. So primarily today we're going to talk about branching into the real estate market if you want to get licensed to be a realtor, or if you would like to look at getting your loan originator license. So there's many avenues. There are many resourceful tips and websites out there that can help you. So today we're just going to kind of give you a few little ideas and a few tips on websites that you can visit if you are looking to get into either one of these areas of real estate.
So the first thing we're going to talk about is getting your real estate license. So a really great start for you to get your license is you want to visit the Texas Real Estate Commission or www.trec.texas.gov. If you go to this website, we're actually going to put that on the screen. It's right here. So you want to click on Become Licensed. And then that is going to, you want to hit Real Estate Sales Agent. And then that's going to give you several steps that you will have to follow in order to get licensed. So it seems like a lot, but TREC is a really, really great resource for you. It's really going to guide you on everything that you need to do, how many hours you need to take. And I think Kelly's going to explain a little bit about some of the requirements, just briefly go over a few things that are required for that.
So right up front, as you begin the process, of course, go to the TREC website. They'll give you tips on what you need to do, but you will need to get fingerprinted. You will have to complete 180 hours of classroom time. And it can be classroom time. It can be most of the websites nowadays offer everything online. So you can get licensed. You can do your real estate license online. You can do your loan originator license online. Now, they usually do have a time frame. So it could be maybe 7 days, it could be 2 weeks, it could be 30 days. It will give you those options, but most of these classes can be done online. Then once you finish that, you will take your final exam for both. So you do have to take a final exam for your realtor license as well as your loan originator license. And then at that point, you'll decide on what broker you would like to work for. And that's a very important step in deciding your future in this market and in this business. And we're going to discuss a little bit of tips on how you decide what office you would like to work in after you've completed your coursework and taken your exam.
So this is the fun part. I love talking about finding a great office to work in. And one thing I would say is we would highly recommend that you start interviewing brokers while you're getting your license, while you're taking your classes. Find out a little bit about who's popular in your area. What brokerage is, are people going to in your area and why? Ask questions. So don't wait until you get your license or until you pass your test to do that. Really start diving in while you're taking your classes and while you're getting your licensing in order. Go ahead and start interviewing your offices. So one of the things that you really, really want to do is you want to look at the office culture. That's really, really important because that's going to determine what kind of space you're going to be in. You want to find out, do you want to be in a big office? Do you want to be in a smaller office? There's some really large brokerage offices, especially in the Texas area, but there's also some smaller brokerages. What do those offices have to offer you? If you are brand new to the industry, you really may want to consider finding an office that's going to support you with education, kind of hold your hand, if you will, through the process, and really walk you through and guide you through the industry as a whole. There's a lot to learn. Once you get your license, and I think we said this last week, it's kind of like driving a car. You're really not sure how to do it till you just jump in and do it. So really determine what kind of support do you need and do you want.
There are some I'd like to add, sorry to interrupt you, but I'd like to add to that as well. One of the questions too you need to ask, especially being new in the business and being a new realtor or a new loan originator, does the office that you're looking to work in offer education? And what we mean by that is, do they have maybe weekly or monthly classes to keep you up to speed on what's going on in our industry? Just because you take these courses, you pass the test, you get out there and you start working in the business, it is ever changing. We are always having new guidelines and new policies and procedures that we have to follow. And so it's very important that you keep up with those changes. So finding an office that really works with you to help keep you educated and keep you up on the changes in the industry is very important. Additionally, you want to consider compensation. You know, what are your goals in getting into this industry? Are you looking to be a millionaire? You're going to work very hard at it. Are you looking to work part-time? Is this just something that you're looking to get into as maybe a hobby? And so those are really things that you need to ask yourself before you get into the industry. Now, I will say that if you are looking into getting into the business to make money, consider this, that there is a financial investment up front in both aspects, both becoming a realtor and a loan originator. You have to remember, you're basically self-employed. You are investing in your future and in your business. So we definitely
But you can also ask, when you interview an office, find out if they contribute to some of those expenses. Some of your offices will help pay for some of those expenses for
some
you.
Of the marketing,
the marketing. You have to buy signs. You've got to buy business cards,
website.
You've got your name badges. Just a slew of things that you may not consider when you're getting into the business. So really, do your due diligence. Ask the office what they contribute to your business. How are they going to help you grow your business? Mm-hmm. And how are they going to back you? And again, the education is important.
Absolutely.
Very important.
And another thing you need to decide too, if this is a full-time job for you and you do plan on going into the office every single day, which I personally would encourage.
But there are some virtual offices now, too.
Well, that is true. And if you have a virtual office, that is great. Most of the virtual offices have a portal that you can actually log into. You can work from that portal. You can interact with other either realtors or loan officers. And I highly encourage that because you're going to learn from other people, watching other people, listening to other people, looking at the experiences that they're going through. You'll learn a great deal by actually just being in the office or
present
and working the business. One of the things too is going into the office does allow you, it's kind of a home. It allows you to get up, you have your routine. It is a full-time job. You get out of this business what you put into it. If you put 1 hour of work a day into your business, then you're going to get 1 hour out of it. If it is a full-time job for you and you work 8 hours a day and you treat it like a business, then you will reap the benefits of working a full-time job. I think we have a video of our office. Do we not have
a video
of our office? I'd like to kind of show that.
This is an example of, and we'll kind of go into this when we start talking a little bit about the mortgage side. But for us, in creating an office space, we really wanted to create a space for our team. This is actually us on a Monday Mania meeting. And we really create a space for our team that is like a home. We want them to be comfortable. Anna, you can see, has Pierre. That's her little dog.
We love
and
our furry
we
friends.
We love our furry friends. But we really encourage our staff to, you know, if they want to bring their pets into the office, they are there a lot. Everyone in our office works hard
days, long hours, and we want them to be comfortable. We want to create a space that feels like home to them, that they want to come into. We really bounce ideas off each other. So really consider when you're choosing a space, what kind of space do you want? What kind of environment do you want? So I think this is a great segue into kind of bouncing out of the real estate side and into our mortgage minute, which we have in every show. But I do want to say, please reach out to us if you have questions. We are happy to kind of walk you through more in depth the steps of getting either one of these licenses and getting into the industry. This is just kind of a recap of how you get started, but we really encourage you to reach out to us. We're very passionate about this industry and about helping people get into the industry that really want to build a career, not just
Absolutely.
A job, but a career. So, Kelly, why don't you kind of start us off on steps, what it takes to, you know, get into the lending world, which is pretty different.
There's
a lot of rules and regulations and laws that go into it.
Most definitely. Again, as we discussed, the licensing aspect of it, the education, keep in mind, the more educated you are, the more value you bring to your realtors as well as to your buyers, the consumers. So it's a very important education. Cannot stress it enough. One of the other things when looking into choosing an office to work in, you know, ask the questions. Of course, always compensation. What are your compensation packages? That can be anything from pay structure to benefits, 401k, insurance. So ask all of those questions. Of course, that's always very important in choosing a place or a home to work in. But as far as on the lending side, find out what the policies and procedures are. What are the underwriting? What are the policies and the structure as far as processing a loan, underwriting a loan? What are turn times? How fast can you get a loan from app to close? And that's very important. Is that 30 days? Is it 45 days? Is it under 20 days? I know typically in our branch, our average turn time on a loan is 15 to 20 days, which is remarkable in this industry. So that gives you value to take back to your client when you start closing loans. So that's very important. Also, talk to the other employees. I know when Kristy and I bring a prospective loan officer into our office, we bring them in the office and we have them meet our staff. We have them meet with our processor. We have them meet with the other LOs in the office because you want to feel comfortable working in that office. You want to feel comfortable with the other loan officers, with the managers, with the underwriters, and know that if you have a question and you need help, that you have someone that you can go to and you don't feel uncomfortable about that. I know in our office too, we are all about helping each other. There's not a single person in our office that we can't go to and ask a question. We all help each other. There's no, it's not, you know, we're not fighting over a business, and that's a very good environment. So that kind of goes back to the culture as well. What type of office are you looking to work in? Some people want to get up every day and go into an office. Some people would prefer to work virtual. And I will say on the lending side, more so probably than on the real estate side or being a realtor, a lot of times we don't even see our buyer until we get to the closing table. So what we do, a lot of what we do is virtual, and having great communication and building those relationships is vital. If you can meet with your prospective buyers in person, I always encourage you to do so. It's most important. Human interaction is always most important, I believe, than over a computer. What do you think, Kristy?
Well, I think in this industry for sure, and that's one thing that we really love about the industry, is that is never going to go away. Mm-hmm. You have to have that human interaction. You're always going to have it. But really, if you're, you know, if you're looking to get into the lending world, into the mortgage world, really the first step you want to do is you want to visit, there is a National Mortgage Lending System, NMLS, and I think Holden was going to put that website up. That will kind of be your first step in where to go if you really want to get licensed. If you click on getting started, licensed individuals, it's going to give you the steps. You're going to have to choose your state. What state do you want to be in? Because each state is different. Understand the rules and guidelines of each state.
But that is your first step. Now, if you've never been in the industry, a really, really good option for you is to maybe start in an office. Maybe, you know, reach out to an office, try to process, try to be an assistant, really, you know, get some experience under your belt, learn the industry a little bit. A lot of offices will license their employees. You know, one of our processors, she wants to get licensed. So we are happy to do that for her. It's really a win-win for all of us. So find an office that's going to support you on your journey. That's so important. Also, finding a company. You know, we talk a lot about your office space and being in an office. You really need to find a company,
that's reputable. For yes. Sure. That is, you know, when people, because we do, and I'm sorry to interrupt you, but because so much of what we do is online, and we do go, the first thing we do is go to the internet to try to find, okay, where are we going to go for this? Where are we going to go for that? And so being part of a reputable company that actually has the backing, that has reviews, that has, you know, a background in the business that you're trying to get to is vital mm-hmm. to your business for sure. It's vital to supporting your business. So before we
know
wrap
their
up,
product, know their product
well,
mix.
Absolutely.
You know, do they have products to offer? That's mm-hmm. a really big deal in the business. You know, understanding the products, understanding their processes, their, you know, operation system. Do they have, you know, an entire office that's committed to just guiding you and assisting you and helping you? Can you call someone? Can you pick up an underwriter? Can you pick up the phone and call, you know, your closer when you're in a situation and you need to talk to someone? So really, really research your company before you choose where you're going to work.
In wrapping up, I want to say this so that we don't keep you all day. But one of the things that we talked about in our last podcast was building your relationships with partners. And I will say in the real estate industry, for those of us that have been in it for a long time and those of us just getting into the industry, it is vital that you have great relationships with your real estate partners. And what I mean by that, that's your title companies. That might be your insurance agent. That may be your appraisers, your inspectors. So make sure that you have those great relationships coming into the business. And also, whatever office you work in will have relationships as well. But one of the things we get asked a lot is, how do I get business? How do I go out and get business? And
if you're self-generating.
Correct. One of the important questions to ask is about marketing. What type of marketing does the office offer? And I'm going to let Kristy wrap up with that before we wrap up, since you handle a lot of the marketing in our office.
Well, you just want to make sure that you have, and it may not be important to you. You know, there's different offices. There are some offices that are more of a call center, where they're going to, you know, refer leads to you. You're going to be calling, and that's a very, very different environment. So that might be an environment. If you don't want to be someone that's going to be generating your own business and self-leading, then that might be a great opportunity for you. If you're someone that really, really wants to grow your business, build your business, and make it your business and build a career that is solid, ask about marketing. What kind of support do they have? Is there someone there that's going to help you? What I find is that a lot of people in the lending industry are very numbers oriented. They love to work with numbers, and that's what they should be doing. But if you talk to them about, do you know how to network? Do you like to go to events? Do you like to meet people? They're like, oh, not really. So that's something that we really, really encourage you to talk about and ask when you're interviewing in an office. Find out, how are they going to support you? How are they going to help you grow your business? How are they going to get you in front of realtors? And will they get you in front of realtors? Because they may not. Are they going to contribute anything to your marketing budget and help you do that? Give you resources, tools, and kind of walk with you in building a business. So not all offices are the same. They're very different. So you really need to decide what you want your business to look like. And it's a journey. You may go in one direction and say, you know, I really think I want to go in this direction. So at the end of the day,
you may change. You honestly may start out and have what we tell our loan officers in the beginning of the year when they set their goals is choose 3 to 5 areas that you really want to focus on, and those are the areas that you're going to work on and get in your business. And you know, it may be that one area is stronger than the other, and so the next year you try something different. It's ever changing, and part of marketing too is also changing with the industry, changing with our market and the industry and things that are happening. So sometimes what works for you today may not work for you tomorrow. But those are questions to ask, and also ask the other loan officers in the office that you're looking in. Ask them what their business looks like. Ask them about the pros and cons. Remember, when choosing and deciding to get into this industry, the beautiful part about it is that you work for yourself. You get to choose where you work. You are worth every penny that you spend on yourself, plus you are worth every penny that you make. So ask the questions. You can also interview the offices and make sure that the place that you're looking is the perfect home for you.
So wrapping up today, we've given you a lot of information about just kind of getting your toes wet in the industry. But again, we very, very much encourage you to reach out to us if you have more questions, if you need more guidance and where to go. We can refer you to some offices that we know that offer education if you're looking for a real estate broker. We can also help give you a little more information on how to where you might want to go to take your classes. So just definitely feel free to reach out to us. We're here to really be a guide to you and to help
you. Absolutely.
And so next week, we will have a guest here with us.
It'll be a fun week.
And we're going to be going over the trends of loft living. What is loft living in this new
urban?
And we
talked about that last week, too.
Yes.
So it's very exciting. And I will say that whenever we offer this class, which we actually have a class going
today,
on right now.
Yes.
And so whenever we offer this class, it's always full. It's a huge class. It's a very popular
lifestyle.
Urban living right now is very popular. So make sure you tune in next week, because we will have a lot of great information. Our guest is fabulous.
Fabulous. And we will have one of our fabulous loan originators, Anna, with us. And we call her our condo queen. So we're really looking forward to seeing you next week. And in the meantime, we hope you keep it real and keep it simple and be very prosperous. Cheers.
And make it a great week.
Yes. Till next week, friends.